You're finally a shrink, and for the first time in your life, you look like you need one.
Maybe it worked out pretty well then.
I have something for you. Athena.
For luck. For luck. For luck. For luck.
For wisdom. For wisdom, for wisdom, for wisdom.
Reality is a very difficult concept.
I know.
You can't stay.
No, I can't. I'm on my way to work.
Miles to go before you sleep.
Something like that. But I will always be here for you.
We'll try. Right. Are you real?
Always. You know that.
Okay.
Your rent's late.
I said we were closed.
2 weeks. Again.
Spend a lot of time stroking things when you're alone.
I don't know. He was in here, was he? His truck's outside. He came here to see somebody. Probably you.
Why, probably me. You give me my money, or you and your freak can get a new place to live.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Welcome to Mulligan's. I will be your server, and are you ready to place your order?
Oh, water with lemon, please.
Yes, I'd like a Coke, thank you.
Ice water and also a Guinness.
I think I'm gonna go with the cheeseburger.
Just everything on it.
Medium.
Medium.
Medium well.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Actually, this isn't what I ordered.
I don't really think this is quite right.
Can you take it back? This is totally wrong. Okay, you know what? I am really, really sorry about that, and I'll get it fixed for you in just a second, okay? I'll be right back.
The economic challenges that we face weren't created overnight, and they're not going to be solved overnight. Our economy as a whole just isn't producing nearly enough jobs for everybody who's looking.
Can I talk to you for a minute? Okay. Now, you need to understand that I've done everything that I can to keep everybody I have right now, but we're not doing the business we did last summer. Even with the new ads we put out, I can't afford to keep...
The point.
You were the last one hired.
Jesus. You couldn't have told me this 5 fucking hours ago!
Calm down.
Don't tell me to fucking calm down! I could have been at home!
I thought that you might have wanted the extra tips. What are you doing?
$692.76. This includes a past due balance of...
Do you really have to do that here? Well, it's almost dawn.
Yeah. For you, maybe.
You know, that's the first thing that you said to me since you got here.
Well, I don't exactly come for the conversation, sweetheart.
Glad to be of service.
Yeah, most guys would be. So what the fuck is your problem?
I don't have a problem.
Then don't get pissy with
me. I'm not pissy! I'm just...
You're what?
I'm sick of this.
You're sick. That's cute, but there's too much sickness in my life already. So do me a favor and save yours.
Nobody is forcing you to take care of him by yourself. You know that, right?
Motherfucker, you are coming dangerously close to a line you do not want to cross with me. Am I making myself perfectly clear?
I can't do this anymore, okay? If you don't want to be here, if you don't want to be with me, then maybe you should go. Yeah, I don't mind at all. Just go ahead and keep my shirt.
You know you can't hide from me. I'm part of you. I'm in your blood.
Then I'll drain it.
Oh, really?
That's what it takes?
You don't have what it takes. But if you'd like to try, here's your chance. It's real.
Nothing with you is ever real.
You wish that were true. But in the back of your broken, twisted mind, you know it's not. I define you, and I know what you're made of. Is that the best you can do? You'll have to bleed every last drop before I let you go. Go on. Make it all go away. Once and for all. And now you know. You don't have what it takes.
After the tone.
Hi, you've reached me.
Yes, I met and have a.
Please record your outgoing message after the tone.
Hi, you've reached Mr.
I love you so, my love.
Please record your outgoing message after the tone.
Hi, you've reached Dr.
First picture taken in this house. It's worth 1,000 words.
That depends on the words.
How about your name?
Doesn't feel right.
Say doctor first.
That's the part that doesn't feel right.
You should be comfortable in your skin. Oh. What about the house? How do you like it?
I think it's empty.
Not for long.
You're going out?
Yes.
In that?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Do you do that because you want people to think you don't
care? I'm not one of your patients.
Thank you.
I never liked coffee. My father used to drink a cup every morning with his newspaper. I never liked newspapers either. The real world depresses me.
Sorry about your camera.
Accidents happen.
Well, in my experience, shit happens.
That too.
I will replace it.
I'm not worried about that.
I'm worried about something.
What do you mean?
Look, I don't want to be rude, but somehow I doubt that smashing your camera instilled you with an overwhelming urge to get to know me, so.
Okay, I am worried about you.
You don't know me.
Empathy doesn't require familiarity.
What makes you think I need someone to worry about me?
Your shoulders are hunched. Won't you tell me what's weighing them down?
I don't know you either.
Precisely why you have nothing to lose.
Okay. I'm broke. I'm fired. My car just broke down. I'm about to be homeless, and my brother is insane.
We're all a little crazy.
No, we're not. I like this.
It can't be that bad.
He asked me if I was real yesterday. Yeah. That's what people usually say.
Is he in some kind of treatment?
Yeah. Mine.
Have you taken him to see a doctor?
Why the hell does everybody always ask me that? I took him to see a shrink once who suggested electroshock therapy. One trip was enough for both of us.
How about taking him to see another doctor?
With what for money?
You could send him to a mental health clinic.
No more goddamn doctors, okay? Straight jackets, zombie pills, lobotomies, none of that shit qualifies as medicine.
So you do it alone? Must be difficult.
Difficult? He was first in his class at a school of 2,300 students. He was accepted to Oxford to study cultural anthropology. One day he told me he couldn't sleep. A week later, a book had whispered to him. Within 6 months, his mind was completely gone. It was like watching him bleed to death. So yes, it has been difficult. And I would just love to know what the fuck someone like you knows about difficulty. This is the crazy bitch that you pitied a minute ago. And I'll be in touch about the camera.
My mother was mentally ill. She died when I was 13. I never talk about that. Well, if you are fired, broken, homeless, you can't do it alone.
That's how I've always done it.
Look where it got you.
Ilza, do you know what a begin is?
Ein Beginn ist ein Anfang, Herr Major, oder nicht?
Sorry, nein. Diesmal muss ich Sie unterrichten. Begin, nicht begin, is a Latin dance.
Aha, ein südamerikanischer Reigen. Bitte sehr, dann lass uns beginnen.
The begin.
Still friends. What doesn't sound right? Your name. Why doesn't it sound right with doctor first?
My whole life, I knew what I wanted to do. Studying kept me focused or distracted. Either way, I never gave it a second thought. Until now.
You're afraid you don't want to do it. Discontent is the first step in the progress of a man. I have a favor to ask.
You told her that I would treat him.
I told her you could help.
Anything else you want to volunteer me for while you're at it?
Her life is falling apart. What could I have said?
You could have said no. I didn't mean... Look, I sympathize with her situation. I do. I wouldn't be very good at my job if I didn't. But I treat people who are depressed or anxious. Everyday things that can happen to anyone. I can't treat somebody who has psychosis.
Why not?
Because it's like fighting a Panzer tank with a pea shooter. I can't help him.
You can help him find another doctor. You can get him started.
You're not hearing me, sugar.
You're not hearing yourself, honey. I know you can't be the one who pulls him through this. Just meet him. Talk to him. Point him in the right direction. Tell me again why doctor doesn't feel right.
You're not at work.
Listen. I've been thinking, and I want to take you to see a doctor. Okay. Don't be afraid.
I'm not afraid. But you are. Desperate, too. One day, one of us is gonna have to live without the other. I don't want you to suffer.
Hey.
Wait! Wait!
Okay.
I can find it.
You can what?
I can find it.
By yourself?
You should be somewhere else.
Okay. It's right down the hall. Right there. I'll be back in an hour. Hey. 1 hour.
Said the cat, we're all mad here. I'm mad. You're mad.
Must be, or you wouldn't have come here.
This isn't an office.
I lost my keys. I'm locked out.
Your building is empty.
Practice closes on Saturday.
It's Saturday?
It is.
And no one else is here.
No, we're alone.
I don't remember the last time I was alone. Is it still Saturday?
Yes. Would you like to take a seat?
Won't stay still.
That's the DSM
for Catalog of Classifiable and Theoretically Treatable Mental Illnesses. I wonder which one I have.
Why don't you sit down? Do you know why you're here?
Because I'm crazy.
That's not quite the way I'd put it, but your sister has asked me to perform a diagnostic evaluation. Once that's complete, we can discuss possible avenues of treatment. First, I'd like to get started with your medical history. Where did you get that?
I don't really know.
Is it real?
Evidently. 20 steps or less. It's God's number.
What?
Any Rubik's Cube can be solved in 20 steps or less.
I want you to listen to me. I need you to put that down.
Which one?
The gun.
Why? I'm not gonna use it on you.
Then you wouldn't mind putting it down.
As it happens, I would.
Why?
I need it.
You said you weren't gonna use it.
On you. The walls don't like me. Is that a common problem for your patients?
I don't know.
Walls in the hallway were much more polite. Would it be unconventional if we left the office
I don't think we need to worry about conventionality at this point.
Is it because it's Saturday?
Among various other reasons.
I didn't know you could do that.
Do what?
Send a text message to 911.
You can't. Not in most places, anyway.
The walls are at it again. Can we leave the office?
If you give me the gun. My oath binds me to be honest with my patients. As soon as you give me the gun, we can leave.
Do you think you can fix me in 20 steps?
For letting me use the truck.
When friends are for, as they say. Speaking of which, who was that?
Some guy. I guess regular people might call him my boyfriend, whatever.
But you wouldn't.
I don't get it. You know, you cannot drag most guys kicking and screaming into a serious relationship. Somehow, I land the one guy on the planet with more estrogen than the fucking Octomom. How's that happen?
I want to be with you forever.
Really? That shit is annoying.
Well, tell him to leave.
I have. He never gives up.
Really? He doesn't give up on you?
Here they come, da 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 da. Sticks and stones may break my bones, but thoughts can make me crazy.
You can't always boil insanity down to a yes or no issue. It's not that simple.
Computers perform maddeningly complicated tasks, but they speak only in binary code. To them, something's either one or zero. Yes or no?
You cannot reduce someone's life to a number. The human experience is more complicated than that.
The human experience is devastatingly complicated, I grant you that. But define insanity.
There are hundreds. Thousands of definitions.
Define insanity.
Habitual commitment to an irrational behavior.
Apt. But curious, I've never met anyone who has not met that criterion. Case in point, cop who dedicates his life to chasing the most dangerous people on Earth, a fireman who dedicates his life to running into burning buildings, or a doctor who is obsessed with people like me? The human mind gone wrong. I argued that all three of these constitute habitual commitment to technically irrational behavior. According to your definition, they're all insane.
I'm not sure that I believe in technical irrationality. But maybe you're right. In any event, we need them.
Absolutely. The manifestations of their insanity, their madness brought to life, is socially beneficial. Craziness isn't always bad. But a cop is no more sane than the criminal he hunts, and a fireman is no more sane than the arsonist he combats, and a doctor is certainly no more sane than the patient that he treats.
Why is it irrational to want to serve justice, or save lives, or help people heal?
Because it can kill you. We're programmed to avoid harm. Survival is the goal of every human instinct. Pain prevents us from severely damaging our bodies, and fear prevents us from severely endangering our lives.
Not everything that frightens us is a threat. You have to learn to differentiate.
You're telling me to be judgmental?
No.
You should. People say you shouldn't be judgmental. But there's no logic in that. If you weren't judgmental at all, nothing would stop you from cavorting with serial killers or rapists. That would be an exceedingly dangerous way to live.
You wouldn't want to go too far in the reverse.
Misery can be so much easier than happiness. Happiness requires work. Misery can be comfortable because misery can be familiar. So familiar. We don't even realize how unhappy we are until we've exhausted our capacity for self-deception. We never keep secrets from others nearly so well as we keep them from ourselves. People always chase what they call happiness when they should be far more interested in satisfaction. We don't just enjoy having what we want. I'm not sure we enjoy it at all. We only enjoy acquiring it. We like winning, even when there's nothing left to achieve. We just don't know when to quit. We refuse to be satisfied.
Maybe we just don't know how.
It's a skill, like any other. It requires practice, practice, practice. Do you believe that insanity is individual to man?
No. But I certainly think it's most prevalent in human beings.
That's quite a cross to bear, isn't it? Why?
We're special. We are advanced. You know, there are more connections between the neurons in your brain than there are leaves on trees in the Amazon rainforest.
Precisely why some of them are doomed. With so many variables in the remarkable human equation, some of them are inherently flawed. Failure is inevitable. Like the rising of a tide. Have you ever met a person who wasn't defective in some way?
Machines are defective. We are not machines.
Of course we are. Electrochemical rather than mechanical. based off of DNA rather than blueprints or schematics, but we are machines, and machines are subject to malfunction. And we don't come with a user's manual.
We have things that no other living creature has. Imagination, enlightenment.
Obsession, misery, and hatred. You're right. Nothing else has those.
What about the ability to heal?
Do you believe in the butterfly effect?
I'm not quite sure that I understand.
It denotes chaos theory. It maintains that the tiniest, most seemingly insignificant action can result in monumental consequences. Do you believe it?
Yes, I think I do.
Do you therefore believe that at some point in your life, something you did, some tiny, seemingly insignificant action, resulted in some kind of disaster? Maybe you cut off an ambulance that was just a little too late to save someone. Maybe you gave bad directions to a stranger who never made it home. What if you caused the death of another human being and you never even knew it?
I guess I always took it for granted.
As well you should. There's some things in life that we must take for granted. We'd never leave home if we didn't take for granted that we'd survive to reach our destination. You can't take things for granted if nothing stays the same. It's like trying to walk in a straight line, but no matter what you do, you can't put one foot in front of the other. The wind blows you over, or the ground moves, or your feet just vanish. Did you know that it's a myth that humans only use 10% of our brains? I mean, we can only use a limited amount at one time, but the gamut of our activities span the brain's potential. Why do so many people insist on believing that we only use 10% of our brains? They want to believe that we can evolve, that we can become better than we are. But what if this is it? What if we have progressed as far as we can? It's not much to be proud of, is it?
Well, I don't know. Galileo, Socrates, the Taj Mahal.
Spanish Inquisition and slavery and the Holocaust. Galileo was arrested for heresy, Socrates was sentenced to death, and the Taj Mahal is a tomb. One of man's most enduring tributes to death. One of our favorite obsessions.
Hang on a second.
What the hell are you doing?
I have been many things in my life. Six impossible things before breakfast. But there's nothing quite like being one of God's mistakes. And he does make them. Either that, or he has a sick sense of humor. If he's even there at all.
I'm not a theologist.
Yes, you are. Serotonin, dopamine, norepinephrine. Those are the gods in your pantheon. OCD, depression, schizophrenia, those are your demons. You're a priest. A confessor.
You're an exorcist. There are more things in heaven and earth, Horatio, than are dreamt of in your philosophy. Maybe there's nothing wrong with me. Maybe you don't see the things that I see or hear the things that I hear because you're limited. Maybe I see the way the world really is. You're the sick one.
No, I don't really believe that either. Never know who I'm gonna be when I wake up in the morning. The butcher, the baker, the candlestick maker. Do you think I'm intelligent?
I think you're brilliant.
If I were an idiot, would I be worth saving?
Life is always worth saving.
That's a good answer.
Then calm down.
But intelligence is overrated. Persistence is vastly more productive. A lot easier to live with. Can't live like this. Every day, it's like drowning. I can feel my mind slip, and there's nothing I can do to stop it. You will never know how horrifying that is.
You don't want to do this. You could have just killed yourself, but instead you came to see me.
I was hoping you would talk me out of it.
20 steps. 20 chances, 20 lifetimes.
Nothing changes, and everything changes.
And this is my butterfly effect. My failure leads to a tragedy.
I asked you to do something impossible. Don't blame yourself.
What about your sister?
She'll recover. It's like you said, the ability to heal.
Some things don't heal. But you can learn to live with them. You can cope.
If you do something for long enough, you forget how to do anything else. I don't know how to be a normal person.
You never told me your name.
My name is Legion.
For we are men.
I'm ready to come down now.
Can you bring your shirt back? I washed it. I don't have any fabric softener, but the detergent at the laundromat smells really nice. I think it's lavender or something like that, so you're not allergic to lavender or anything, are you?
If you are, you just don't wear it.
I saw the news. Your brother made Rupert Murdoch a couple bucks. Is he alright?
Yeah, he will be. Just, you know, I'll probably be able to take him home in a couple days. And everything will just go back to normal. No, he's gone. I took him, and he can't see me for a while.
All right, look, if there's anything that I can do...
No, that's not why I came. I meant to say... Sorry. Sorry.
As I live and breathe. How are you?
I'm good. How are you? How's the practice?
Actually, I think that's behind me now. Thinking about becoming a professor.
I'm really good at that.
What about you? What are you up to?
I'm good. I'm back in school for social work.
You'll be good at that.
Thanks.
You know, there are a lot of things about myself that I might never have learned without you. Thanks.
Would it kill you to fold your sheets?
Fail to see the purpose.
You, of all people, ought to understand the importance of having a little order in life.
And you, of all people, should know that order has never been my strong suit.
Touché. Well, I gotta hit the road here pretty soon. Listen, I am going out of town this weekend, but I will see you as soon as I get back, okay?
The voices in my head approve.
I'll just wait outside.
Peace.
I thought it was funny.
Yeah, hilarious.
Your symptoms seem better.
What symptoms?
Withdrawal.
How did... Right. They are better.
I'm glad. Did you forget something?
I never did find the keys to my office.
Hello, Doctor. How are you?
I was going to ask you the same thing. How are your new meds?
Better. Not quite right yet, but...
Improving.
Improving.
I have something for you. Athena.
For wisdom?
For luck. I'm still part of you. And I always will be.
I know.